Tigers, their second baseman. Texas Southern as a team with a batting average of 200. Herrera in the series has batted twice and struck out both times. Watches a 90 mile an hour fastball from Washburn off the plate. One and two to Herrera. Gus, the smell of sunscreen in the air this afternoon.
Yeah, no doubt. We're starting this ball game at 79 degrees.
Forecast to climb into the low 80s. The wind, which had been stronger earlier in the day at 27, 28 miles an hour, have died off a little bit, but still blowing out to center field today. So there could be an adventure or two on fly balls.
You know, most of our spring winds, John, are, as you know, our crosswinds here, blowing out to left and left center. This one today, straight out. This is the old Wrigley Field. Wind's blowing out today.
Off the lake.
Yes.
Herrera has worked the count full at 3-2. Ground ball right back to Washburn on the mound, and an easy toss to Stripling, and there's one away.
Washburn will use all three pitches, fastball, breaking ball, change. In fact, he used all three in that sequence there to Herrera. Good feel for both of his secondary pitches. He'll pitch usually between 88 to 91. At least that's what he did last week. That's what he did so far. Herrera.
Herrera on the way back to the dugout stopped and spoke to Chase Cromer, who is now at the plate, before heading back into the dugout. Cromer fouling off the first pitch from Washburn. That is out of play.
Cromer 1-for-4 so far on the weekend.
Had a single in yesterday's game, had gone 0-for-2 in the opener on Friday. Washburn making the 42nd appearance of his career. The ball popped up behind home plate, going to drift back into fair territory. Washburn's got to field it. There's no one at first base, though. Landon Stripling came in on that high ball that appeared, Gus, as though it would land in foul territory, but there's the wind coming into play.
Yeah, we just talked about that wind, and we think about it in terms of what it's going to do to balls out in the outfield, but on foul balls hit straight back like that, it's going to push that thing out to the field. That's going to go, actually, John, it appears, as a foul ball.
Yeah.
Maybe one of the Red Raiders picked it up in foul territory, I guess.
Big swing and a miss on the high fastball, and Cromer is out.
Yeah, a bit of an unusual sequence there.
Yeah, I thought that ball had drifted back into fair territory.
Too. I guess one of our guys picked it up. He had Stripling. Had a long run to go, and Bazell never saw it, and that was probably the key when Washburn tried to help out there. Didn't have anybody covering first, but fortunately they grabbed it before it rolled fair.
This is Lazo, the guy you highlighted at the start of today's broadcast, and he comes through right on cue. His fourth hit of the series and the first that does not go for extra bases. A single there for the DH for the Tigers.
Yeah, Poppy thought that ball was hit a little sharper than it was, and so unable to time his jump. He could see him sort of jump and try to slow everything down to let that thing get to him, but a bit of a changeup hit out there by Lazo, and it threw Pompey's timing off just enough to get that ball into left field for the base hit.
Now with two outs and a runner at first, it's first baseman Jose Villalobos. Villalobos has struggled against Red Raider pitching, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts on Friday. struck out again on Saturday in five plate appearances. Runner goes. Bazell's throw is into center field. Harrelson comes in to pick that up, and the runner, Lazo, headed towards third, and he'll make it. Bazell just airmailed that throw over Lopez at second base into center field.
Lopez tried to do a good job at Deacon Lazo there as he kept the tag on him, making him think that the ball was there at second. You can see him right there hanging the glove in hopes that the base runner doesn't see it. But Lazo sliding feet first usually allows you to see that ball a little bit better, and he saw it out to center field. And one thing that will affect the offense today is these outfielders throwing into this 20-25 mile an hour wind.
That's the first stolen base of the series by the Tigers. Dylan Maxey had thrown out an attempted base stealer at second yesterday. Washburn has gone full on Villalobos at 3-2. Only a 158 hitter, but he does have two home runs and four driven in. High fastball gets him, and the inning is over. Washburn strikes out two, allows the single. Tigers got a runner, 11 trips to the plate. He's been on base seven times. Watches that first pitch in for a called strike. Castro began his collegiate career at Panola College and with Texas Southern, today making his 33rd career appearance. Lopez lifts that second pitch deep into left field. Drifting back on it is Cromer near the warning track and makes the play. Here's the Tigers defensively today. Cromer there you just saw in left, Nin Burns in center, Rafael Gross in right. It's Alford at third, Jones playing shortstop today, Herrera at second, Villalobos at first, and Michael Godeau behind the plate. Austin Green batting 500 in this series against Texas Southern, 3-for-6 with a double. He's driven in four runs and scored four times. His 440 batting average is second best on this Red Raider team.
Castro with the best arm we've seen out of that Tiger pitching staff, 86-88. So far here with the fastball.
Allowed only one extra base hit in that first start for him this season. It was a home run by Southern.
Trying to land a little 2-1 off speed pitch there. Now he pitches behind Austin Green, 3-1.
Austin already here earlier in the season has five doubles. He hit 14 a year ago, but took him 24 games to get to five. He is seeing the ball well for sure.
Castro missed with a 2-1 off-speed pitch and landed a 3-1 breaker there.
Green hits that one right to Villalobos at first base. Tigers first baseman scoops it, steps on the bag, and the Red Raiders have two away.
Yesterday, Dominic Martinez was a tough adjustment for these Red Raider hitters. Soft throwing left-hander, had really nice feel for both sides of the plate early. Scoreless through three innings until the roof fell in on him. But Castro, a little bit better arm here, a little bit better pitch selection.
Kevin Bazell with two out. The grounder to Alford at third, and his throw across the diamond in town. The Red Raiders haven't gone in order many. Gussie's wondering what happened to the offense. The Red Raiders have not gone in order very often in this series. And before that bottom half of the first inning, 16 trips to the plate and at-bats for his team, only five times in those 16 trips, and the Red Raiders not scored at least one run against Texas Southern.
It's really been obviously a tremendous offensive weekend so far for the Red Raiders, setting a school record with 32 runs scored here on Friday. And yesterday, oddly enough, was the day the wind blew. Friday, it was as calm as could be in here. Not a super offensive day in the ballpark, but man, the Red Raider hitters took advantage of a ton of free passes on Friday, and I think 6 Texas Southern errors and set a school record.
5, 6, and 7 in that Tiger batting order. Jaden Jones at shortstop today. CJ Castillo not in the starting lineup. Their preseason all SWAC shortstop.
It sort of makes you wonder if Castillo might be utilized on the mound today, because he has played as a two-way player. Yesterday he was very good here. First hitter of the game, solo home run, later had a sac fly and a base hit. So I don't think he's in the coach's doghouse.
Yeah. Jones drawing the full count walk from Washburn. Tigers have their second base runner of the game. Here's center fielder Nin Burns, 2 for 6 in the series. Both of those hits have been singles, and he skies that one into shallow right center field. Lopez was going out, but Harrelson coming in from center field, making the play.
Well, those shallow fly balls are going to get pushed to outfielders today. That's going to help a little bit. These guys will have to back off a couple steps in the outfield with the wind in their face. That'll also make it tougher to throw to bases. Probably going to be a lot of first to third on base hits and guys scoring from first on doubles and that sort of thing.
Here's right fielder Rafael Gross with one out and a runner at first. 0 for 2 in yesterday's ball game, but he reached twice on a walk and hit by pitch. Junior out of Pearland has 4 hits on the season. Goodeau, who waits on deck, the Texas Southern catcher, has 5, and that's the most on this team. Swing and a miss.
Yeah, Goodeau, their leading hitter this weekend. He's been very good. And they would love to set him up with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Goodeau 3 for 4 in Saturday's second game. Boy, Washburn making a living staying upstairs, Gus, his 3rd strikeout.
Yeah, he does a nice job of that. Working at the top of the strike zone with the fastball, especially after establishing that good breaker. Good changeup. Did that last week in Arlington as well.
Runner goes on the pitch to Goodeau. Here's Bazell's throw down. Lopez can't quite get the tag on Jaden Jones.
Yeah, that throw just a bit to the left field side out there at second, and that was probably the difference in Jones being safe and out.
Second stolen base of the afternoon for the Tigers.
Yeah, when that throw is to the shortstop side of second or the left field side of second base, you have to reach out there and go get it and pull that tag back, as opposed to it being on the first base side and you can just catch it and let him slide into the tag. Takes just an extra split second, and that was probably the difference there.
First stolen base of the year for Jaden Jones, and he's in scoring position. Goodeau's 3 singles yesterday. Washburn began his collegiate career at Oregon State, spent the 20 and 21 seasons there, appeared 25 times for the Beavers. Five of those were starts, then a transfer to Ole Miss where he was part of their national championship team. And Godot swinging and missing at a fastball from Washburn ends the inning. Tigers leave a runner in scoring position. It's 2015, 2017, and 2018. Red Raiders have been pretty successful in NCAA tournament play for sure, Gus. Yes, oh, and Washburn to lead off. It's McGee after that, then Stripling.
Red Raiders would love to get back to Omaha.
Been there four times, 2014, 2016, and back-to-back trips in 2018 and 19. Oh, and Washburn did not play in yesterday's game, went 0 for 2 with a couple of walks on Friday in that game where the Red Raiders scored 32 runs. As a hitter's count at 3-1. Hit that one pretty deep to left field, but it's going to drift foul.
Said this a couple times already, but there's Castro landing a 3-1 breaking ball. He is mixing pitches effectively.
Breaking ball there is just off the plate. Nolan Washburn's on with the base on balls. He's the first Red Raider base runner today.
Scott Chesser, our home plate umpire, Sam Cayeen at first, Cale Smith at second, Trey Plummer at third.
Yeah, free passes have certainly helped the Red Raiders offense today, or in this series. Seven walks yesterday, but 14 in Friday's game. McGee has one hit in this series, the transfer to Texas Tech from Gonzaga.
Yeah, you mentioned the free passes yesterday. The Red Raiders scoreless through three innings. Grounded out to start the fourth, and then it was three walks that fueled that inning.
Fly ball into left center field. Moving over there is Nen Burns to make the play. Cromer kind of gave up the chase, and he and Burns are talking about that now in the outfield. But McGee unable to move Washburn up, and there's one away.
The wind will be in their face. You know, all three of those outfielders yesterday, that crosswind was knocking balls down to right field. Not so today. But not a cloud in the sky either.
Nothing to get in their way for sure. Where Landon Stripling had quite the game on Friday. 5 for 7 at the plate. His first two trips, he flied out and struck out. But the next five were pretty memorable. He doubled, he hit back-to-back home runs and ended the game with a couple of singles and 7 runs driven in. All by the true freshman out of Lawrenceville, Georgia. Ball on the ground right at Jones at short, and it is a inning-ending double play. Jones to Herrera.
Again, just a foul ball. It probably took a souvenir away from a fan. But these big high fly balls back here behind home plate will get pushed onto the field.
It's 9-1-2 for the Tigers of Texas Southern. Dalton, Alford, and then back to the top with Herrera and Cromer. Alford ground ball right at Lopez. Throw to Stripling's in time, and the fourth batter in a row retired by Red Raider starter Jack Washburn.
both of these pitchers effective so far, mixing pitches, throwing everything for strikes. And I say that, not that every pitch is a strike, but landing all of their off-speed stuff, all of their secondary stuff, commanding the fastball.
Herrera grounded out right back to Washburn on the mound to start this ball game. Gus Washburn in no danger of using up all of the time on that pitch clock. He gets right back up on the rubber and throws.
Yeah, you gotta like that.
That ball rolled right at Stripling, the young guy at first base, and Herrera is retired for out number two.
Yeah, fielders love playing behind the guy that works quick and throws strikes.
Washburn has struck out four so far in the ball game, gives him 10 for the year. He allowed one hit, that to DH Jason Lazo, who is on deck now as Cromer bats with two outs. Skies that one into left field, drifting back is Bravo. Harrelson coming over, and that one gets out of here. Cromer gets that ball up in the air, and the ballpark can't hold it. First home run of the season for the Tigers left fielder.
Cromer getting that one just over the wall, probably helped by the wind. But they all count. You can see Bravo taking his route. He starts curling back, and that thing just over the wall in left center.
Not sure that Cromer thought it was going out when he hit it, and it looked like Bravo felt he had a bead on the ball, but it just kept going. And that's the direction of the wind today. Second hit allowed by Washburn. It's the first home run he has allowed this season. And Lazo, who singled in that first inning, back at the plate. Here's a pretty well hit ball into right center field. Owen Washburn there, as is Gage Harrelson. But they can't make the play. Lazo has hit it out. Back-to-back home runs for the Tigers here in the third. Texas Southern with those two long balls lead the Red Raiders 2-0. Lazo 2-for-2 with a single and the home run. Washburn, Gus had just been working his way through the order, had retired five in a row before those back-to-back home runs.
And that ball right there might have been the most sharply hit of all three of them in this inning. First two big fly balls, probably wind aided to get out of here. And that ball right there hit on a line to right field for the base hit.
Hit right at Washburn's brother Owen in right field. And now after getting the first two batters here in the top of the third, three in a row have reached base. Two of them just circled him. Chase Cromer's home run followed by Lasso's home run. And then Villalobos with a single into right field. Brings Jaden Jones to the plate behind at 0-1 in the count. Jones walked to lead off the second but was stranded there when the next three batters were retired by Washburn. Four hits by Tigers batters today, a couple of singles and two home runs. Southern had hit only five through their first six games, but have added two more here this afternoon. Now Washburn walks Jones for the second time today. So Villalobos moves over to second. Jones at first with two outs. And center fielder Nin Burns to bat. Burns has had a hit in each of the first two games. Both of them singles, and now Gus. Red Raiders want to talk to Washburn.
Yeah, and what you don't want after a couple of probably wind-blown home runs is to let a guy get too affected by it. And that's an easy thing to say from up here in the up here in the press box, because he's the one dealing with the frustration of giving up.
Red Raiders in this series, though, have hit 21 balls for extra bases. Five of those are home runs, so this game a long way from being over. Burns flied out to Gage Harrelson in center field back in the second inning. Swing and a miss there, now 1-2.
Washburn started him with a good breaker. Burns swung over for the first strike, then tried to get the fastball chase with the second one. It was up and out of the zone. Comes right back with another good breaker and another good swing and a miss.
Check swing, they'll call it strike three, and Burns is out to end the inning. It's the fifth strikeout for Jack Washburn, but damage done with the back-to-back home runs from available on the ESPN app, so you can watch at work or anywhere else. Seven, eight, nine in that Red Raider batting order. Damian Bravo, TJ Pompey, and Gage Harrelson due up against the starter Josiah Castro for Texas Southern. He has set the Red Raiders down in order, as it turns out, in both the first and the second. A ground ball double play by Stripling ended the second inning. But this is the Red Raiders' hottest hitter this season, Damian Bravo.
And that's another Andrew Brothers Roofing foul ball.
Bravo 6-for-10 in this series with three doubles. Has eight doubles for the year. That's most in the Big 12. The Red Raiders as a team lead that category, as they did last season. With more than 40 hits in this series coming into today, have climbed to the second spot in the Big 12 in terms of team batting average at 357.
This Tiger outfield playing very, very deep, as they have most of the weekend, and that will create some opportunities. Hustle doubles, that sort of thing. Soft base hit somewhere. Want to hit first base, dig it.
1-2 pitch to Bravo, and he gives it a ride to center field, and it is over the monster in center field. Wow. Bravo's first home run of the year, and he hit it straight away.
That was a bomb to center field. Bouncing that over there to the engineering building. Ball crushed.
Damian Bravo gets all of that one for sure. Not sure, Gus, if the wind played a role there or not. I mean, he got what he wanted, and yeah, he made a good swing. Red Raider fans don't like what's just happened. TJ Pompey, the Red Raiders freshman shortstop at the plate, hit by the first pitch from Castro.
TJ shoots a look out there at the mound after that fastball clipped him. Like, yeah, okay, here we go.
Poppy has had an outstanding series, was 8 for 12 before that, his first appearance at the plate, but hit by a pitch and he's on base. Bravo's home run a moment ago, the 11th of the season for the Red Raiders.
This Tiger Ball Club has given up a bunch of stolen bases this year. But you really want to be sure if you're running today on a day where the wind's blowing out like it is, it's going to be offensive enough without risking base runners.
That ball got away from Godot, and hurrying down to second base is Pompey. Harrelson,
a wild pitch.
Yeah, Harrelson didn't play in yesterday's game, had a single on Friday, one of the 24 hits the Red Raiders had in that game.
Yeah, with just three games this weekend and no midweek game coming up, three games next weekend, Coach Cadillac trying to spread some at-bats around. There will probably be some inner squads this week on Tuesday and Wednesday to get more guys to the mound.
Harrelson led the Big 12 with five triples last season. Has one this year.
What a soft base hit for Gage. And I say that, just a ground ball up the middle, something like that. Gage Harrelson needs to hit the bag aggressively at first, because he could be one of the guys that legs out a stretch double here with this outfield so deep.
I think that'll get down lined into right field. Coming on for it is Gross. Pompey's on the way home from second base, and he will score without a throw. And Gage Harrelson does deliver with that run scoring single into right field.
Not great arms in the outfield for the Tigers, and also throwing into this wind today. And so you're going to see third base coaches, Coach Thomas especially, being aggressive. And if they threw at Pompey with any intent, probably doubtful that they did, but if they did, it cost them a run.
That's Harrelson's fourth run driven in this season, and that base hit has tied the ball game at two runs apiece. And now Tracer Lopez, who flied out to left in his first at bat. Lopez tripled in Friday's game, showed bunt, takes it for a called strike.
Tracer eyeballing offered over there at third. He was a couple steps behind the bag.
He's got great speed, and Alford is still not moved in. Lopez lifts one into right field. Gross drifting back, he'll make the play. Is the ball not hit that deeply? And Lopez is retired for the first out here in this third inning.
Tracer out in front of a little off-speed delivery there. Got that one off the end.
Here's Austin Green, who rolled one down to Villalobos at first base in the first inning. But his 12 runs driven in are most on this team. He and Pompey share that distinction with 12. Green has three doubles against Tiger pitching through games 1 and 2. May have another here. Hit that one really hard to left field, but moving over is Cromer to make the play.
Yeah, that ball well struck, smoked right at Cromer. He just took a couple of steps to glove that, about chest high. A really good swing there by Austin Green. It's frustrating as a hitter, but you don't want to change your process when you hit a ball like that.
Kevin Bazell grounded out to third, 0 for 1 today. Has Harrelson at first base with two outs.
Bazell with seven doubles on the year. He's just the right man to score Gage Harrelson from first. We know Harrelson runs well, and he'll be off on contact.
All of those runs scored by the Red Raiders on Friday. Bazell drove in five of them. Moving on the pitch was Gage Harrelson, and Godot's throw gets through into center field, and now Gage around to third base with a 2-0 count to Kevin Bazell.
Gage was over there twitching, trying to get a jump. He was ready to go there.
Stolen base for the Red Raiders center fielder and a throwing error by Godot. Have Harrelson 90 feet away from giving the Red Raiders the lead.
Very deep and straight away in the outfield. Castro lands a 3-0 breaking ball right there. Respect for Devin Bazell.
Freshman All-American a year ago, Bazell, an all-conference preseason pick this year. Bazell swinging at the 3-1 pitch. That's going to land foul down the right field line. And now 3-2.
Curveball, 3-1 curveball there by Castro. He gets them both in for strikes.
That the fastball just sent right back where it came from, over the head of Castro into center field. Harrelson scores from third as Bazell drives in his 10th run of the year, and the Red Raiders have scored three times here in the third inning.
Castro mixing pitches like that reminds me of the old NFL films clip where they mic'd up one of those coaches in the late 60s, Hank Stram era guy, and he's over there yelling advice, watch the pass, watch the run, watch everything. That's good coaching right there, John. That's just good coaching.
I love the mic'd up Hank Stram in
the
days.
No doubt.
Here's Owen Washburn, who walked but was erased on a ground ball double play. I think the most memorable line from Hank Stram is, come on, boys, we're just going to keep matriculating down the field.
Best.
Nothing in two to the Red Raider right fielder. And Washburn, is that going to stay on the playing field? Oh, it does. Cromer can't quite get there in time. Got the ball boy hung up in that mess down there as well.
I think the tramps are having to play the wind as well, because he's thinking, oh, that thing's not going to get to me. And the wind pushes it back onto the playing field, and suddenly he's got three fielders coming at him. Hey, man, y'all be patient down there, fellas.
Oh, he's ready to make a play.
Yeah, you like the mindset. Just be careful.
Nothing and two to Owen Washburn. Could certainly help out his brother's cause here. Owen has not homered this year.
Bazell stole the first base of the year for the Red Raiders in the Tennessee game. So if you had him in the...
What nice job of hitting by Owen Washburn. Two strike pitch just ripped out into right field. So back to back singles that direction.
You had Bazell on the baseball prop bets. We come out of the Super Bowl betting on every opportunities to bet on every possible aspect of that game. But yeah, Bazell.
Red Raiders. Cade McGee with a chance here to add to that Red Raider lead. Junior from Tucson, who began his career at Gonzaga. It's six home runs for them a year ago in limited time.
Yeah, our third base umpire, Trey Plummer, now probably moving our ball boy to the other side of the fence just to avoid any trouble there. Probably about to do that down the first baseline here. Just in case, fellas.
McGee did have a single on Saturday. That would likely score another run for the Red Raiders here. Boy, big cut at an 88 mile an hour fastball from Castro. That home run by Bravo, the second allowed this year by Castro. Castro trying to complete his 81st career inning. But the Red Raiders are making it tough on him. First three reached base, then he got a couple of outs, and now two more hits by Texas Tech. McGee gets underneath a breaking ball, pops it up, but it might land. Coming on for it is Burns, now drifting back a step or two, but he does make the play, and the inning is over. But the Red Raiders come up with four hits. The big one, a home run by
the last half inning. So the Red Raiders remind their guy that, hey, it's blowing out for us too, although I don't think Bravo's needed much help. That thing was a shot out of here over the monster and dead central, 402 feet away over a 20-foot fence.
That's hit well. 7, 8, 9, Gross, Godeau, and Alford. And Gross trying to lay down a bunt, got it up in the air, but McGee cannot get to it. Gross, one of the five strikeout victims by Jack Washburn today. Swing and a miss on that off-speed delivery. 1-2 to the Tigers right fielder.
And that's another Andrew Rogers rookie foul ball.
Gross out of Pearland. He has struck out 8 times in this series, or in the season, rather.
Little excuse me, 2-strike swing to stay alive there.
Yeah, 2 of those 8 strikeouts have come against Red Raider pitching. Washburn got him there, but the ball got away from Bazell. Taking his time on the throw, but is there to Stripling, and Gross retired. Second time for him to strike out today, and one away in the top of the fourth.
Bazell doing a nice job of blocking up a breaking ball. It kicks there over to the third base side. He's got to put a little bit on that one to throw out the hustling Gross there at first. Nicely done, Kevin Bazell.
Godeau also struck out in his only at-bat today, that in the second inning. At one plate appearance in the opener of this series on Friday, he walked in that appearance, but then on Saturday had 3 singles, trying to see if he can lay down a bunt here. That ball off the bat for strike 2. Gus, you've mentioned this a time or two. It's a bit of an unusual schedule for the Red Raiders in that there are no midweek games following this series.
Yeah, and sometimes I would say maybe the oddity there is that sometimes at this point in the season, this early in the season, you'll see Tech either getting a 4-game weekend series with a midweek game, or sometimes 3 weekend games and a couple of midweeks. It's called a strike. Our home plate umpire, Scott Chesser, pointed at Godeau and said, yes, he offered. Fastball down and away. Nice location there for a second out. Yeah, you can see Godeau. That bat clears the plate. Washburn doing a good job of mixing pitches here.
Seven strikeouts now, and he struck out three straight batters. This is Dalton Alford playing at third base today for the Tigers. He grounded out to Tracer Lopez in the third. Quickly finds himself behind at 0-2. Washburn makes quick work of it. Three pitches. Alford chases that for strike three. Eighth strikeout of the ball game for. A lot of interest in that Texas Tech game locally, Gus.
Yes, indeed. The students already camped out over there. They have been fantastic for most of these home games, certainly the Big 12 home games. I'm sure this Tuesday ball game will be no exception.
Yeah, both those teams, Texas Tech and Texas, coming up on the short end of scores on Saturday. Red Raiders back home, where you know Grant McCaslin's team will want to defend the home court, and might be the last time the Longhorns roll into town.
Yeah, certainly for the foreseeable future.
Landon Stripling leading off here in the Red Raiders fourth. Grounded into that inning-ending double play back in the second. Trying to continue his hot streak, hit it right at Dalton Alford over at third base. And nice play there.
Yeah, Landon Stripling doesn't have much to show for it. Two more barrels for him today. The double play ball to end the second. A sharply hit ground ball right on Jones that he gobbled up for the routine 6-4-3. There he lines out the third. He continues his hitting ways. Does Landon Stripling.
Yeah, Stripling had five hits in that game on Friday, but still hitting the ball well. Maybe not as well as this guy did back in the third. Damian Bravo hit it over the hitter's background out in center field for his first home run of the year. He's behind Castro at one ball and two strikes here. Gus got to know that he's not reluctant to throw a breaking ball at 1-2 or at any time in the count.
Yeah, exactly. He's thrown 3-0 and 3-1 and 2-0 breakers today. I'm very comfortable with that. And there's another one right there. Doing a good job of mixing pitches. Yeah, Trey Plummer, our third base umpire, after sending the saddle tramp for foul ball chaser over to the other side of the fence, kind of gives him the thumbs up right there, like, yeah, that's a good job. Jump out of that gate and come on out. Yesterday, one of the tramps got a little aggressive and almost played a fair ball. He looked up and saw the third base umpire and pointing fair and said, you know what, I'm going to let this ground ball go through my legs and into left field, the left field corner for extra bases. So no harm done there, but he did have everybody sort of gasping.
Breaker at 2-2 stays up now full to the Red Raiders left fielder. Three and two pitch. Bravo goes after it, but it will wind up a souvenir. Well, not even that. Wynn kept it in the field, but not playable.
Well, you had fans standing up when that ball left the bat thinking, hey, we're about to get a souvenir, and that's how much wind we've got here in the ballpark as it pushes that one onto the field. And boy, Villalobos just whiffs that. I mean, he was under that pop-up and just missed it.
Gives Bravo another opportunity. Castro delivers outside for ball four, only his second walk today.
Sometimes the biggest fiascos with the wind blowing out like it is today aren't out there in the deepest parts of the fields, maybe where a ball is blown out of the field of play for a home run, but it's on these foul balls that look like they're back here in the parking lot and they end up on the field for an out.
TJ Pompey now hit by a pitch. He would come around to score in the third on the single by Gage Harrelson. Pompey stole second, went to third when the throw by the catcher went into center field. But nobody on this Red Raider team any hotter than TJ Pompey in this series, starting today 8 for 12 with a couple of doubles, a home run, and 7 driven in. That is foul.
The activity in the Tigers bullpen is what you and I suspected, John. It's CJ Castillo. We talked about him as a two-way player, started the first two ball games at shortstop in the series, led off, actually hit a home run yesterday, and he's going to be their first option out of the bullpen, it would appear.
Pompey watches that one bounce in, coming off the bag there at first was Bravo, and hustles back as Godot quickly got to the ball. I'm sure Michael Robertson would like to figure out a way to get Castillo in the game to pitch and in the lineup to hit.
Yeah, there's probably some truth to that, and that could happen. Although their DH, Jason Lazo, has been as good as anyone in their lineup.
Yeah.
Already homered here today.
He's 2 for 2 today with 5 hits in the series, so you wouldn't want to take him out. 3-2 to Pompey. Six-four, 200-pound freshman out of Coppell. Guess he passes the eye test for sure.
Yes, he does.
Breaking ball. It's going to take a while to find that one, I think, over the bullpen in left field. And TJ Pompey has his second home run as a Red Raider. Took that 3-2 pitch from Castro and got all of it.
Castro went back to the breaking ball. Really hasn't missed with many, but this one, the breaking ball over the middle part of the play. Elevated. A hanger, if you will. Pompey jumps on it. Hits it out onto the street out there in left field.
Gage Harrelson, or it was Bravo rather, scoring in front of Pompey. Red Raiders now up 5-2, and Harrelson will bat. It was Harrelson who drove home Pompey in the third. Red Raiders, who had gone in order in the first and second, making it a lot tougher now on Tiger pitching. Harrelson hits one that direction as well down the left field line. Right, oh, jumping up and making a catch on the wall is Cromer. There's your defensive play of the day.
That is a whale of a catch there. The wind fueling this fly ball. Well, not much of a fly ball, more of just a line drive that looked like it had extra base hits written on it. Cromer, fearless, going deep into that left field corner and playing that right off the bullpen gate. Heck of an effort there by him.
That certainly saves a base runner for sure, because that was at least a double for Harrelson. Walk to Bravo, a two-run shot by TJ Pompey here. Now two outs, and back to the top of the order for the Red Raiders and Tracer Lopez.
Tracer didn't like that call. Thought that pitch was in off the plate. He'll hit out of an 0-2 count here.
He's flied out to left and flied out to right in two trips. Sophomore out of Rosebud. reclassified out of high school to become a Red Raider a year ago. Here's the 1-2. Breaker stays away from the left-handed hitting Tracer Lopez. Five runs for the Red Raiders today have all come down at the bottom part of the batting order. Bravo, Pompey, and Harrelson have scored the five runs. Lopez watches that pitch up for ball four.
John, we talked about TJ Pompey in the pregame. 8-for-12 coming into today. Highly productive weekend for him, I would say. He's making a case for Big 12 Freshman of the Week honors. Now 9-for-13.
If you can't get it with that kind of number, I don't know what you do. First pitch to Austin Green is ripped into right field. Lopez from first all the way around to third. With two outs, the Red Raiders have him at the corners for Kevin Bazell. Looks like Michael Robertson, who has come out of the Texas Southern dugout, has not headed towards the mound yet, but now he is. The day may be over for Castro. Harrelson, and that put the Red Raiders in front 3-2, and it's 5-2 now. Bazell drove in 62 runs a year ago and hit 10 home runs.
Starts Bazell out with a breaking pitch there that misses.
Castillo's 5'9", 165 pounds out of Houston. Hometown guy for Southern, Texas Southern. He quickly gets behind Bazell at 2 balls and no strikes. And that hit him. That hits the Red Raider catcher, second hit batter of the day by Tigers pitching, and that loads the bases.
Like it got Bazell just above the elbow there. Fortunately, he was rolling with it, so a little bit more of a glancing contact there. But now bases loaded with two outs for Owen Washburn. Wash with a walk and a base hit and two trips today.
Chance to extend the lead for his brother Jack, who is the Red Raiders starting pitcher today. Because some of these guys clearly had outstanding high school careers. Pompey is one of them, but the Washburn brothers back home in Wisconsin, both of them were Gatorade Players of the Year in the state and have a pretty long resume of high school success.
Small town Webster, Wisconsin. Of course, really good bloodlines there for the Washburn boys as their father, Jared, what a 10, 12 year, 15 year big league pitcher.
Think they had a batting cage in their yard?
Yeah, probably did, yeah. I hope it was indoor. Probably you'd think the winters in Wisconsin, probably a little harsh.
3-1 now to Washburn as Castillo can't get the breaker over.
Well, I think most folks around this program would tell you that the Washburn boys have been a joy to have on this campus.
Oh, and rip that one foul. Gus, your ball boy, let that one get away from him.
Yeah, he did. He kicked that one.
All right, 3-2 now with two outs.
Base runners will be moving.
Yep. Everybody will get a start. Lopez is at third. Austin Green is at second. And Kevin Bazell at first. There they go. Here's the pitch. It's way off the plate to Washburn. Castillo couldn't get the breaker over. It's ball four. An RBI for Washburn on the bases loaded walk.
Castillo going with the 3-2 breaking ball there. Misses well off the outside corner to walk in a run.
Here's Cade McGee, the Red Raiders' ninth hitter of the inning. He has flied out to center field both times today.
McGee off to a slow start, obviously. And he is off to a slow start in the power department, just one double. But Cade McGee hit a bunch last fall. He has some power. It's just a matter of time before he shows it.
Hit 16 home runs during his time at Gonzaga. Oh, that hit him right in the middle of the back, right between the one and the two. Yeah, Castro's breaking ball just didn't.
Yeah. Big, big miss there with the 2-1 breaker. Nowhere close. McGee is wearing it, as you said, between the one and two. That pitch never even threatened the strike zone. With Castillo really fighting his command here. He can close the book on Castro.
Now back to Landon Stripling, who started this inning hitting a rocket down to Alford at third base. Third hit batter of the day, second by Castillo since coming in. Stripling hits that one a mile high to left field, drifting back on it is Cromer. He's near the wall on the warning track and he makes the catch. The young guy Stripling gave it a ride, but it comes down and got this guy, Jesse Herrera, on a ground ball over to first, but then Cromer and Lazo hit back-to-back long balls. Herrera still looking for his first hit today, chasing that first pitch and grounding it foul over near the Red Raider dugout. Here's a ground ball. Lopez not going to get to it up the middle, and Herrera has his first hit of today's game.
Herrera successfully shooting a ground ball back through the middle there for the base hit, just beyond the reach of Lopez. In his first at bat, he chopped one back to the mound, sharply hit the Washburn glove for an easy out. This one able to get through and then into center field.
First hit of this series, only his second hit of this year. And now Cromer, who struck out in his first at bat, then hit that home run to left field in the third. Washburn with more than 70 pitches thrown today, his 74th coming up. Runner goes. That ball is fouled off by Cromer. Cromer's defensive play on that ball hit back in the fourth inning by Harrelson. Just outstanding.
Yeah, highlight reel stuff there. The Red Raiders with the right-hander beginning to toss out there in their bullpen. Probably the final inning of work for Jack Washburn.
Over chases that pitch and fouls it away. 1-2 is the count.
Again, that foul ball felt like it was back here behind us in the parking lot, and it landed over here amongst the.
Cromer rips that one right down the line past McGee at third base, and that's going to score a run. Herrera's coming all the way from first base as Cromer pulls up at second with the double. McGee was close to the line, but Cromer hit that one hard enough right past him at third base and legs out the double. Herrera scoring. It's 7-3 Red Raiders.
Cromer going down and getting a breaking ball. It's down, maybe down and out of the strike zone, but over the middle part of the plate. He squares it up and hooks it past McGee and into the corner.
Memorable day for the Tigers left fielder with that defensive play, a home run and a double now at the plate. And here's Jason Lazo, who is 2-for-2 today. Singled in the first, solo home run in the third. Rips this ball the other way down the right field line, lands in foul territory. Lazo thought it was fair. The call by Sam Kavine over there. First base umpire.
Yeah.
Puts up the stop sign.
Lazo was running down first base like, no, how did you call that foul? And
call will stand.
Cromer will have to go back to second base here.
Lazo will walk back to the plate and try and do it again. I guess you're right. He wasn't selling it at the right base.
Yeah, out there at second.
Yeah, ought to be here.
You bet.
1-1 is the count. Washburn delivers. That one is fouled over on the same side, but not quite the same part of the field. Washburn has struck out 8 batters today. So hangs in there.
Fastball in there at 92 on his 80th pitch of the day. That per the stadium radar gun.
Lazo, a sophomore out of San Antonio, trying to help rally the Tigers. And Washburn can't sit him down. Ground ball towards Lopez, bobbled it, got to hurry the throw now, and does, and Lazo disputing the call a little bit, hopped up into the air and came down awkwardly. Thought he had a double earlier in that at bat, but the umpires ruled that that was not the case.
Yeah, awkwardly, the key word there is he kind of lunge for the bag. Looked like he was grabbing at his hamstring. Felt like he was safe there. Yeah, he's still kind of gimpy headed back to the dugout.
Yeah.
Thinking, man, I thought I had a double. Then I thought I beat that thing out.
All I got to show for it is a pulled hamstring.
Yeah. Got Cromer over to third with one out. So a fly ball will get him in. Tech going to play the infield back here.
Villalobos singled into right field in his last at bat. He had struck out the first time to end the first inning of this game. Doing nothing is the count. That is the 88th pitch today by Washburn. And a quick throw by Bazell down to McGee at third. And looked like Cromer might. I think those umpires who were reviewing this play are enjoying a nice beverage.
While we're in here.
While we're in there. More than 12,000 fans have attended these three games here in Lubbock.
We're really, really fun opening weekend here for the Red Raiders. A lot of fans coming out for really nice sun-drenched days here at the ballpark. A sellout yesterday and 3,900 today, just short of a sellout.
SWAC preseason polls have Texas Southern, who are in
conference schedule, so 10 weekends of Big 12 baseball, and that will start next week, or excuse me, in 2 weeks, 12 days.
All right, after all of that, the call at third base confirmed that Cromer was indeed back in safely. So we're right where we were a few minutes ago. 3-0 the count to Villalobos, one out and a runner at third for the Tigers. Everybody back in place, and Washburn has walked Villalobos. His third walk in this game. And now with one out, runners at the corners.
Coach Jadlock here with that pitch count up there.
Yeah.
Around 90 pitches. He's going to be calling for his right-hander.
Yeah, had that call at third base perhaps been an out and you got Villalobos maybe to fly out or ground out to end the inning, but Tim Tadlock has seen enough with runners.
Reviewed and then a pitching change.
And here's Jaden Jones, who had walked twice in two appearances against Washburn. Sanders making the 40th appearance, or 39th rather, of his Red Raider career. All of those have come in relief for the senior out of UConn, Oklahoma. Here's a ground ball past the diving Stripling at first base. That'll score Cromer from third. As Jaden Jones delivers with his first hit of the afternoon, Villalobos going around to third base, so they just change spots here. Get their second run in the inning. As Jones delivers on the RBI single, and it's now 7-4.
Sanders gets the ground ball he's looking for, but that one had eyes. Stripling over there holding the base runner on. With a step and a dive, but unable to come up with it.
Had he been playing deeper off the bag, likely would have made that play. Runner's going to go. They're going to lay down a bunt. Burns right in front of home plate. But they're not going to be able to squeeze the runner in from third. Kevin Bazell makes an outstanding play. Throw over to first base in time. And Burns out on the attempted bunt.
Yeah, and that's a safety squeeze there that Burns is trying to attempt, and what you're trying to do there with the runners on the corners is push it to the first baseman who's holding the base runner on and occupied. You got to get that thing up the first base line. You got to get the first baseman involved, and Burns is unable to do that.
Here's a ball hit right at Lopez off the bat of Gross. And Sanders is going to get the Red Raiders out of a jam here. That ball hit right at Tracer Lopez, who fields it on a hop. Gets it over to Stripling, inning over. Pompey and Gage Harrelson do up. Pompey was hit by a pitch in that third inning and would score on the single by Harrelson. And then in the fourth inning, Pompey hit his second home run as a Red Raider. But Bravo, with the home run and a walk, has been on twice and scored each time for the Red Raiders. In fact, five of the Red Raiders' seven runs have come from that trio of Bravo, Pompey, and Harrelson.
Bravo and Pompey here today. Trying to see who hit one the farthest. Bravo's winning that one, by the way, so far. The ball he hit to dead center over the 20-foot hitter's backdrop, 402 feet away. Ball was smoked.
Pretty impressive. Takes one up and in from Castilla. Castillo entered in that fourth inning. And there's ball four as Damian Bravo walks for the second consecutive time.
Castillo wanted that call there. He thought the breaking ball caught the inside part of the play. He has faced five hitters and passed out four free passes, hitting a couple and walking a couple.
not exactly what Michael Robertson would have wanted, I think, when he brought him in from the bullpen.
Here is a right-hander working in the Tigers bullpen. Yeah, John, I think you're right about that. For sure, the result's not ideal, but Castillo not in the starting lineup at shortstop after having spent 2 days at shortstop and batting leadoff. Probably so that he could be available on the mound and maybe maximize an effort here on the mound, but not sharp so far.
He's faced five batters for the Red Raiders, and four of them have reached base.
Castillo has missed a bunch to his arm side, which means inside to the right-handed hitters. He's hit a couple, missed several times to that part of the plate. The Red Raiders would love to extend this lead beyond a single swing of the bat.
Poppy just ripped that 3-0 pitch into center field. Burns is going to get there quickly and get it back over to third to hold Damian Bravo at second base. But T.J. Poppy has his second hit this afternoon. And Gus, his 10th of this series. Is he 10 for 14 now?
Yes, that is correct. Again, extending his candidacy for
newcomer of the week in the Big 12. Wow.
Freshman of the year, freshman of the week, rather. I'll take freshman of the year as well.
Yeah, that's not out of the question.
Getting ahead of myself there.
Came to the Red Raiders after being ranked as the number one shortstop in the state, one of the top 100 players in the country. He has not disappointed at all. Two hits today on base, all three trips.
Long mound visit by the catcher, Michael Godeau. Gage Harrelson runs well enough that if Alford wants to, okay, now he's coming in. I was thinking, man, if he's going to play that deep at third base, Gage might push one that direction. Just as I was about to say that, Alford got yelped at by the dugout, and he takes about three steps in. Now he's even with third base.
Or he's listening to the broadcast now.
Well, that's true. I need to be quiet. Yeah.
You're giving away secrets.
That's right.
Castillo just cannot find the strike zone.
Again, another big arm side miss there. That breaking ball spins out of the top of his hand. That looks like the one he threw to McGee that hit him between the one and the two on the back. He is really fighting his command.
83 on the radar gun on that pitch, but he came in back in the fourth, immediately hit Kevin Bazell, walked Owen Washburn, hit McGee to load the bases, but then Landon Stripling flied out near the wall in left field to end the inning. But here in the fifth, he's walked Bravo and given up the single to Pompey. Swing and a miss, though, by Harrelson, and he's in a 1-2 hole.
Castillo with a good change there. Pulls the string on Gage. Harrelson way out in front of that one. Another breaking ball and another huge miss. By the way, congratulations yesterday to Wes Kitley.
Oh, yeah.
The men's track team wins the second straight indoor Big 12 championship, and the women finished second. Another arm side miss for Castillo. The frustrating part there is you want a guy to be able to make an adjustment. I mean, just about every one of his misses has been to the arm side.
Here's a 3-2. Harrelson fouls it away.
Castillo entered with runners on first and second the previous inning, hit a guy to load him, and then walked in a run. Hit McGee to drive in another run.
Harrelson rips that one past the diving Villalobos at first base. That is going to score Bravo. Pompey is headed towards third. Throw is cut off in the infield, and Harrelson delivers with his second single of the day. Another run for the Red Raiders, now 8-4.
Gage tattoos this ball just off the glove of the diving Villalobos. Good effort there, but unsuccessful. Pompey all the way around to third base. Still nobody out here. Coach Robertson out, taking that slow walk to the mound.
Pompey a single and Harrelson a single. Harrelson singled, scored Bravo, making it 8-4. Red Raiders have 8 hits to go with those 8 runs. And now Justin Barnes in to face the top of the Red Raiders batting order, and Tracer Lopez, who is 0-2 today, but did walk and score in the fourth inning. There's nobody out for the Red Raiders. This is a Red Raider team that had scored 52 runs in the 2 previous games. 89 on that first delivery from Barnes for a called strike. And his first breaking ball is off the mark. Runner first base goes to second. Here's the throw by Godot, but off the mark. As Jaden Jones, the shortstop, took the throw. He was looking at Pompey over at third, but not trying to move there. But Gage Harrelson gets his second stolen base of the day.
The infield stays back for the Tigers. They'll trade an out for a run. Say that Leo Villalobos, even with the bag over there at first, something hit sharply to him, could be played to the plate to get Pompey.
Lopez does have 1 home run this season, hit that against Oregon.
It's a good day to elevate a fly ball into the outfield and drive in a run here. Less than 2 outs, runner on third. Sacrifice fly opportunity abounds, and the wind's blowing straight out. So see what happens.
Lopez doesn't get the chance. Barnes comes in and walks the first batter he faces. And that loads him up for Austin Green. DJ Pompey is at third, Gage Harrelson at second, and now Tracer Lopez at first. Austin grounded out to first in his initial at bat today, hit a line drive to Cromer out in left field in the third, but did single and score in the fourth.
Texas Southern playing their middle infield at double play depth here. They're looking for a ground ball, turn a double play.
They did just that back in the second inning.
I thought Barnes was close to balking there, not quite to a complete stop, or maybe just barely to a complete stop. It's a better way to say that.
Austin Green rips that one. That is a fair ball, no question, down the right field line. He's got at least 2, and the Red Raiders are going to score a pair of runs. As Lopez is held up in third, but Pompey and Harrelson score on the double by Austin Green. The Red Raiders now have 10 runs.
Austin smoking one into the corner there. Thomas there at third base holding up Tracer Lopez. Still nobody out in this inning. He's going to take the chance of making the first out at home plate, especially on a day where the wind is cranking out like it is. Bazell with a really good opportunity to plate a couple more runs here.
Ground ball right at the second baseman, Herrera. It will score a run. Pull Villalobos off the bag, but he gets back to it before Bazell gets there. But the ground ball does get another run across. Lopez on that play. Austin Green over to third. And there's just one out for the Red Raiders here in this fifth inning.
Get him over, get him in. That's what he did by hitting the ball to the right side of the infield.
Now Owen Washburn. Owen's 1-for-1 today, but he's walked twice. Been on base all three at bats.
The infield stays back here.
Red Raiders started the day with 28 doubles, most of any team in the Big 12, and have added that one from Austin Green. Austin has 6 doubles this season. And now with 21 career multi-hit games. Owen starts the day a .348 batting average after his season a year ago cut short because of injury. It's a towering fly ball. It'll be deep out in left center field, and it may be out of here. It is. Burns and Cromer were giving chase, but Gus, that one just kept on going for the Red Raider right fielder.
Yeah, that ball well hit. On any normal day, it's got a chance to get out of here. But today, with this jet stream out to center and left center, that big towering fly ball just flows out there onto the street and bounces over into the parking lot. Exactly what Wash was looking for there. Good day to elevate something, take your chances with it blowing out of here, but above all else, you pick up that run.
His 11th career home run makes it 13-4 Red Raiders. Here's Cade McGee. Looking for his first hit today. But he was hit by a pitch back in the fourth inning with the bases loaded, forcing in a run. That one right over his head from Barnes.
Now is as good a time as any to say that today the run rule is in effect, or at least that's the word we got earlier. Now with Tech playing with a 9-run lead, they need one more and then hang on for 6 more outs.
Yeah, that would only come into play in the 7th inning.
10-run lead after 7.
McGee on for the second time today, but that by the walk, as Texas Southern pitcher still just having trouble finding the strike zone. Stripling is the 9th Red Raider to bat here in the 5th inning. With 2 outs, he's grounded into a double play, lined out to third base and flied out deep to left field. He started the opener of this series on Friday and had a pretty memorable day when he went 5-for-7 with a home run.
Landon can hit. The ground ball he hit was sharply hit and right on the shortstop for the 6-4-3, and then you mentioned the line out. So he's had a couple of decent swings today as well. Nothing to show for it yet.
Red Raiders batted around 3 times in that game on Friday when they scored 32 runs. They batted around once on Saturday. They've done it already once today, and if Stripling reaches base, they will have done it for a second time. Damian Bravo, who led off the inning with a walk and would score, is the guy on deck.
The Tigers have a right-hander beginning to play catch in their bullpen.
Red Raiders came into this ballgame today the top hitting team in the Big 12 in terms of number of hits and runs scored.
Yeah, this early in the season, a 32 run game will do that for you, followed by a 20, right?
It will. They've got 105 hits on the season. And there's ball four to Stripling.
C.J. Castillo's day is done. One third of an inning, three runs, they're all earned. Walk two, hit two, and allowed two base hits.
Well, Michael Robertson out of the Tigers dugout. If he was walking any more slowly, Gus, he wouldn't be moving. think more batters than the opposition has. Red Raiders nearly five innings into this third game have struck out only six times in this series.
This Kansas ball club returns back to Houston. They play Wiley on Wednesday afternoon and then hop on a bus, I assume. Maybe hopefully a flight for them, but I would assume it's a bus, and they will play four games in Lawrence, Kansas against the Jayhawks next weekend.
Yeah, they're in a stretch, Gus, where they play 18 of 19 on the road.
And they follow that with a Tuesday game at Texas A&M, so challenges ahead for the Tigers.
They've got one right now with Damian Bravo at the plate. He's walked twice today and scored and also hit his first home run of the year. Towering shot back in the third over the hitting background out in center field. Garcia's got a problem with two Red Raiders on. Eight walks today. Cade McGee is at second. Landon Stripling at first. Bravo's the guy that began this inning with a walk. And on the corner, a cold strike to Bravo, now 2-2. Bravo starts today with the Red Raiders' best hitting average, up over 500. It's not gone down with a home run, officially one for one. Three and two now to the Red Raider left fielder. Gets it through on the left side on the ground. Cade McGee is going to score. Stripling will stop at second, but Bravo, a two for two day, and he's on base for the fourth time in this game. Just driven in his 13th run of the year.
Damian jumping on that two strike pitch and ripping it through the hole over there. Drives in McGee from second. Stripling advances to second. Still just one out here.
TJ Pompey has a 2-for-2 day going. Home run in the fourth inning. He singled in the fifth and scored. Was hit by a pitch back in the third and also scored. Scored the run that tied this game at the time at 2-all. Gets it down to third. Alford on his knees, makes a play, steps on the bag there to force Stripling. Pompey will be safe at first on the fielder's choice, but now two outs for the Red Raiders. Bravo down at second base, and Harrelson bats for the second time in this inning. Singled to score Bravo earlier in the inning. He can do it again.
You know, the one out Gage made today was a really nice running catch by Cromer out in left field as he made a nice leaping catch, crashing into the bullpen gate down there deep in the left field corner to take away extra bases from Gage.
Might see that one on the highlight reel, but Cromer made an outstanding play. He's the 12th Red Raider to bat here in this inning.
John, you mentioned it. The Tigers have thrown pretty much every pitcher on their roster here in these first two plus games.
Yeah.
The only one left that's appeared in a game is their third baseman, Alford.
There's ball four to Gage Harrelson.
So there might be a point, and again, we talked about the run rule being in effect here, but there might also be a point at which the coaching staff looks over there at Isaac Garcia and says, hey, big fella, you got this.
Good luck.
Got to get four more outs.
9 walks today by the Tigers. And now Tracer Lopez, who's walked twice. He's walked twice and scored on each of those. Flied out in his first two at-bats. So 0-for-2 for Lopez today. It's a pretty well hit ball into left field, but Cromer's got a lot of room this time and is able to make the play, and that ends the fifth.
Relief against Nebraska in the Red Raiders win over the Huskers. Allowed 5 hits, hit a man, struck out a couple.
Starts Michael Godot with a 91 mile an hour fastball. Left the breaking ball up. Godot today has struck out twice. Godot, who had 3 hits yesterday, has struck out twice today, once swinging and once called. All of the 8 strikeouts by Tiger batters came against the Red Raiders starter, Jack Washburn. Josh Sanders faced 3 batters in the fifth. Allowed a single, but then a couple of ground ball outs ended the inning.
Mac Hewer drafted out of high school last year. The Red Raiders were glad to get him to campus. And I say drafted out of high school, he was actually homeschooled.
There's his first strikeout this afternoon as Godot strikes out for the third time. 3 hits yesterday, 3 strikeouts today.
91-92 almost first few fastballs, and that one right there downhill at 94. Just pumped it by Godot.
That's the way baseball go, Gus.
Yes, sir.
Now Dalton Alford, who's 0 for 2 today with a ground out and a strikeout. Ewer starts him with an off-speed pitch that's off the plate for a ball. Mentioned that things really go south for Texas Southern. Alford has pitched in two games this season. In fact, he's taken the loss in each of those. Three on the gun on that 3-0 pitch for a called strike. Ground ball towards Lopez at short, or at second rather. And there are two out here in the top of the sixth. Ewer has come in, retired the first two batters he has seen today, and now Jesse Herrera, who is the leadoff batter for this Texas Southern team, grounded out back to the mound to Washburn to start the ball game, then grounded out over at first base. Did single and score in the fifth. Tigers got a couple of runs in that inning. They also got two in the third.
That fastball misses at 95. And the stadium radar gun to give you an indication of the arm. Mac Ewer. Lots of 93s and 94s. He bumps a 95 there. And that's why the Cleveland Guardians drafted him in the 16th round. You see 6'5", 260 pounds. You see that fastball on such a young arm.
Inside out swing by Herrera past McGee over at third base. Herrera is headed for a second. For a double, as it takes a while for Damian Bravo to run that ball down. It was spinning such that it didn't go down the left field line. It immediately after getting by third goes into foul territory, and Bravo's got a long run to get to that ball.
A little humpback liner that just faded over there and laid against the wall. Bravo had a long way to go. Although Herrera, thinking double all the way, probably wasn't going to try to stretch that into three. Herrera inside out and a little breaking ball there by Ewer. Slicing it down the third baseline.
Second double of the day for the Tigers lineup. Gives them a runner out there at second base with two outs. Here's Cromer, who's had the highlight day for these guys. Struck out in the first, but then in the third, homered to left field, and he doubled down the left field line in the fifth. Hits it right back up the middle, past Ewer, into center field. It's going to score a run. Herrera's around to score back-to-back hits now off the young Red Raider pitcher.
Ewer tried to get some of that ground ball and keep it from squirting into center field. Trying to Coley that thing up, keep it on the infield to keep that runner from scoring from second, but unable to do so as Cromer shoots it past him and into center for the hit. Chase Cromer's a triple away from the cycle.
Yeah. 3-for-4 day for him, batting in that two hole. But now Jason Lazo, who's got two hits today, had a single in the first inning, came with two outs. Not able to come around and score, but he followed Cromer's home run in the third with a solo blast of his own out to right center field. Grounded out in the fifth.
Dylan Maxey doing a nice job of blocking an off-speed pitch there. Able to keep it in front. He'd probably prefer to deaden that a bit, but that got a bunch of the mask and kicked out there to the mound. Cromer not moving.
Two hits in this inning give the Tigers 9 for the game. That ball lifted by Lazo down the left field line, but Bravo is going to run out of room.
Normally that thing's bouncing off the roof down there in the left field corner, but you want to stay with those balls today as the wind's blowing straight out. It kind of straightens out some of those foul balls. There's a look at that new facility. The existing facility was down there. They just added a bunch to it. Beautiful space down there. $14 million project, I believe, completed this past fall.
Runner goes, 1-2 pitch. Throw is a bit wide of the bag from Maxie. Pompey makes the catch there, keeps that ball at second base, but that is a stolen base for Cromer. 3-for-4 day with a home run and a double, stolen base. Highlight reel catch in left field. Swing and a miss by Lazo, and that will end the inning. Hewer strikes out two, but he allows the single. Yeah.
Gonzaga last year. We have a new catcher and a new left fielder for the Tigers.
Austin Green, Kevin Bazell, it'd be Dylan Maxey up for Bazell. And then Owen Washburn due up here. The first three for the Red Raiders here in this bottom of the sixth inning. Some defensive changes for Texas Southern. Will Gus surveying the lineup.
Victor Molina, their catcher, has now appeared in all three games in this series, all as a substitute for Godot.
Austin Green doubled in a couple of runs, and his last at bat came in the fifth. He's got a 2-for-4 day going. One of four Red Raider regulars who came in today with a batting average over 400. Might have chased ball four there, but fouled it off.
Noah Butler, the new left fielder. Butler, I believe, making his first appearance on the weekend.
Three and two pitch, a breaker inside to Austin Green. He's on base for the third time today and the 10th walk allowed by Tiger pitching. It's a way to get yourself into trouble against these guys. Dylan Maxey came in the top half of this inning behind the home plate for Kevin Bazell.
Yesterday got the start and hit a long one. Rolled it down the street out there beyond left field. Three hits in that ball game.
Hit that home run in the bottom of the seventh inning, a two-run shot. His fifth career home run. Damian Bravo and Owen Washburn also hitting home runs today along with TJ Pompey. But that just adds to the list of Red Raider home runs from now from nine different Red Raider players.
Hudson Parker, the right-hander, working in the Tech bullpen. Working with the sort of pace that would make you think he's going to pitch the top of the seventh.
Dylan, the sophomore out of Friendswood, hit .247 for the Red Raiders a year ago, had four home runs, drove in 22. 3-for-5 on Saturday with a home run. Josiah Castro started this game for Texas Southern. C.J. Castillo relieved, then Justin Barnes, and now Isaac Garcia. Austin Green not going. Ground ball towards short. That's Jaden Jones to second for one. Austin Green, oh, slides underneath there, upends Herrera a bit, then Herrera shoves Austin Green, and I think he's just been ejected.
Yeah, I think you're right. Umpire Cale Smith just tossed Herrera. Herrera thought Green was going after him, and he wasn't.
Yeah, Austin just making the slide there, and then Herrera, after Austin started to stand up and walk away, shoved the Red Raider base runner.
I mean, even if he thinks he's got a case there for some sort of interference or something like that, that's not the way to react to it. That'll cost him his spot in the lineup here and probably have to go take an early trip to the bus. The new second baseman, Shannon Martin.
Well, they'll give him a moment or two to throw the ball around a little bit, get loosened up, but that all coming on the ground ball by Dylan Maxey. Hit it towards shortstop Jaden Jones, who wanted to start the double play, but the ball not hit all that sharply. They weren't going to be able to turn it. You don't think. Austin Green sliding in at second base starts to stand up and gets up underneath Herrera, who then shoved the Red Raider base runner, who was out at second base. But nothing out of the ordinary on his slide. Didn't slide anywhere on either side of the bag, right over the top. But there's the shove that got Herrera ejected. But now Owen Washburn with Dylan Maxey over at first base and one out. Owen is 2 for 2 today, singled in the third, homered in the fifth. And two other plate appearances, walked each time.
A right-hander beginning to loosen in the Tiger bullpen.
Washburn hits this one pretty well into right center field, and it's deep out there near the scoreboard, and Nin Burns can't run that one down. Owen Washburn has his second home run of the day in consecutive at-bats.
Well, that was a bomb out to deep right center. It banged off the street light out there beyond beyond the Texas flag. That ball was really tattooed.
Dylan Maxey scores in front of Washburn. The Red Raiders take a 16-5 lead. Owen Washburn joining some other Red Raiders, namely Landon Stripling and Austin Green, or Woodcox did it. Drew Woodcox with two home runs in games in this series.
Cade McGee's looking for his first long one of the year.
He's just looking for a hit in this game. He's flied out to center field twice, been hit by a pitch, and walked. Three and one the count. Landon Stripling is on deck with one out here in the bottom of the sixth inning. There's the hit. McGee rips that one into left field. Butler will go over and pick it up and get that ball back in, but McGee has his first hit today. And that is the 13th by the Red Raiders in this game.
McGee, the batting average hovering around 230, but the on-base percentage up around 500 on the year. 9 walks, 4 hit by pitches. So even without the hit total numbers just yet, and they'll be there as the season goes along, but he has still been very productive.
Better be careful or he'll be in a leadoff spot.
Yeah, it's true.
Getting on that many times. Stripling is grounded into a double play, lined out to third, flied out to left, and then reached on a walk. Stripling had that game on Friday night when he went 5 for 7 with a double and 2 home runs. A couple of singles. Drove in 7 that night. Gus, that first base position for the Red Raiders in this series has been trouble for the Tigers.
Yes, it has. Stripling wore it out here 2 days ago, and Cash with a couple of hits and a long home run yesterday.
Stripling got out in front of that one, hit it a mile, but foul on the right side. Yeah, his 2 home runs. Cash had a home run. Three and two now to the Red Raider freshman first baseman, and that's outside ball 4.
Kansas State beat Holy Cross in Manhattan today, 5-4. Kentucky beat Kansas down in Round Rock, 8-5. Charlotte beat West Virginia, 6-5.
11 walks by Tiger pitching. 5 of them have come around to score. Stripling is on base now. Damian Bravo bats. Bravo homered in the 3rd. He walked and scored in the 4th, walked and scored in the 5th. Singled in that 5th inning as well before it ended.
TCU on the verge of sweeping UCLA there in Fort Worth, 3-game series.
Frogs are the favorite in the Big 12. Big 12 coaches picked the Red Raiders in 4th in their preseason poll. Swing and a miss by Bravo. That's the first Red Raider to strike out in the ball game today. Comes in the bottom of the 6th inning. Bravo unable to move a couple of Red Raiders along on the bases. Cade McGee is at 2nd. He singled. Stripling at 1st. He walked. Now TJ Pompey has a home run today as well.
Indiana thumping Baylor today in Waco, 11-3.
Pompey is 2 for 3 today with that home run and a single. Here's a high fly ball to right field. Looks like Gross will settle under it. The ballpark will hold it, but the Red Raiders come up with a couple of more runs here in the 6th inning. The home run by Owen.
Here. Run rule is in effect.
Wondered about that coming in, knowing the fact that the Red Raiders did not have any midweek games scheduled before Gardner Webb visits here at Danlaw Field next weekend, but that is indeed the case. It's 4, 5, and 6 in the Tigers' order. Villalobos to lead off. Pompey up quickly on that slow rolling ground ball, and Villalobos is out at first base.
Little jam hop, jam shot, soft roller out there to short. Pompey aggressive with the charge, throws on the run, throws a strike. Indiana trying to sweep that series in Waco, John.
Here's Jaden Jones. Walked his first two trips today, then singled in a run in the fifth inning for the Tigers. Picked up a couple in that at bat. Hit it right back up the middle, off viewer, off his foot, and bounces back over towards the line. They're coming in from third base, and the official score will be a base hit for Jaden Jones. It's just off the foot of the Red Raider pitcher.
Cromer shot a single back through the middle in the last inning that Heuer tried to glove, and this one shot back through the middle. It hits him on the front foot. He gives the thumbs up signal to his dugout saying, hey, I'm all right here. He's looking for a double play ball.
Nen Burns is the batter. 0 for 3 today, flied out to center, struck out in the third, tried to lay down a bunt in the fifth, but Bazell jumped out from behind home plate and threw him out at first base.
Wright State beating Oklahoma and Norma 9-2 in the fifth inning. The Sooners will be here to wrap up the home portion of the Tech schedule in early May.
Red Raider fans are hoping for a wrap up to a very successful regular season. Here's a chance at a double play. McGee at third, to Lopez back to first. Not in time, though, to get Burns. Jaden Jones out at second. The Red Raiders cannot turn their fourth double play of the year.
And for the Tigers, number 13, Rafael Gross
is the last chance. 0 for 3 today with a pair of strikeouts. Ball got away from Maxie. Burns headed towards second, throw down. Lopez caught it on the bounce, but can't put the tag on Burns in time. Red Raiders scored 32 runs on Friday, 20 on Saturday, have 16 today. They've limited the Tigers to 5 runs on 10 hits. .93 on the pitch from Heuer there. We've seen him as high as 95. Red Raiders are not really holding Burns at second base.
Yeah, they're looking for to control the hitter here, get this out, call it an afternoon.
2-2 pitch on the way, ground ball, it's towards Pompey. There's the throw, Stripling's got it, and the ball game is over. Heuer allows the single here off his foot, but the Tigers cannot score, and the ball game is over. Gus, the Red Raiders, impressive again offensively. Jack Washburn good in his start. In the